In this video, I am going to explain theories of chromatography. It includes plate theory, rate theory, HETP and column efficiency parameters. If you are new on my channel, please subscribe it. Now let's start today's video. First, we'll see relationship between Gaussian curve and chromatographic peak. Gaussian curve is also known as normal error curve or normal distribution curve. It resembles a bell shape. It looks like a bell. When replicate values of a measurement are plotted as a function of frequency of their occurrence, then Gaussian curve is obtained, and a chromatographic peak resembles to this Gaussian curve. Now, how exactly the chromatographic peak will resemble to Gaussian curve? We'll see that. When solute molecules are eluted from column, they are not eluted at a time. If they are eluted at a time, the chromatogram may look like this one, like a straight line. But this is not the case. Now, how exactly the solute molecules are eluted from column? When sample molecules are injected to the column, they are traveling with different velocities through the column. Some solute molecules are traveling with fast speed and they come out of the column first and get detected. They will form front portion of the peak. Most of the molecules travel with average velocity and get eluted from the column. They will form central portion of the peak or middle portion of the peak. And some molecules will get lag behind and come out of the column last. They will form end part of the peak. In this way, a chromatographic peak is obtained, and this is the ideal shape of a chromatographic peak. It resembles like a Gaussian curve. When we see a compressed view of this chromatographic peak, it will look like this one. This is the relationship between Gaussian curve and a chromatographic peak. As the solute molecules travel through the column, the band broadening or peak broadening takes place. Peak width increases. This increase in peak width causes poor separation or poor resolution. To obtain an optimal separation, sharp symmetrical chromatographic peaks must be obtained. This means that band broadening must be limited. To obtain a good separation, to get a good resolution, the chromatographic peak should resemble the Gaussian curve. If the band broadening or peak width broadening is there, then poor resolution will be there, poor separation will be there. Why there is band broadening? Why there is peak width broadening? To understand this, one must know two theories of chromatography. First theory is plate theory, which is old theory and developed by Martin and Sange in 1941. And second is rate theory, which is developed by Van Deemter in 1956. It is currently used theory. Now we'll see one by one in detail. First is plate theory. According to plate theory, a chromatographic column consists of a series of discrete yet continuous horizontal layers, which are termed as theoretical plates. Solute molecules get equilibrated between stationary and mobile phase at each of these plates. Now consider this is the column which is packed with stationary phase, and these are the theoretical plates. For our understanding plate theory, we will consider right side of this column as stationary phase and left side as mobile phase. Stationary phase is fixed while mobile phase is moving down the column. At the end of column, there is detector. When we inject solute molecules, sample molecules to the column, they will get equilibrated in the first plate between the stationary and mobile phase. It means that if we inject 100 molecules of sample, 50 molecules will enter in the stationary phase and 50 will enter in the mobile phase. This is known as equilibration, equilibration between stationary and mobile. Migration of solute is then assumed to occur by series of stepwise transfer between one plate to other plate immediately below it. Now stationary phase is fixed, but mobile phase is moving down the column. It will carry, mobile phase will carry the 50 solute molecules with it to the second plate, and in the second plate there will be equilibration of those solute molecules once again. 25 molecules will enter in the stationary phase and 25 molecules will remain in the mobile phase. Again, these 25 molecules are carried to the third plate by the mobile phase. These 25 will get distributed, equilibrated in the third plate also. Now, in this way, the mobile phase will carry the molecules, sample molecules, to the next plate, and in each plate there is equilibration. Mobile phase carries solute molecule to the next plate, and as this stepwise transfer occur from one plate to the next immediately below it, the first few plates in the column becomes empty because the solute molecules are equilibrated between stationary and mobile phase and they are transported down the column with mobile phase. During this stepwise transfer, the separation of solute molecules occur according to their affinity towards stationary and mobile phase. The separated solute molecules will get eluted from column and get detected by the detector. Efficiency of separation column increases as the number of theoretical plate increase and H decreases. Now, as this number of theoretical plate increases, it means that number of equilibration will also increase, and as the number of equilibration increases, separation will be good. Now, what is this H? There is a formula for calculation of theoretical plate, and the formula is N is equal to L upon H, where N is number of theoretical plates, L is length of column, and H is height equivalent to theoretical plate, or we can say height of theoretical plate. One important thing about plate theory is these plates are imaginary plates. They are considered to understand the processes occurring within column. Now this is about plate theory. We'll go for rate theory. Rate theory describes shape and width of chromatographic band based on random walk mechanism for migration of solute through the column. Rate theory is able to explain effect of mobile phase velocity and adsorption capacities of stationary phase, which determines width of band. Rate theory also shows relationship between mobile phase velocity and adsorption capacities of stationary phase with the retention time. Migration of solute molecules in the column occurs in the state of confusion. It occurs in stop and go sequence. When the solute molecule is adsorbed on stationary phase, it is immobilized on it and its movement down the column is temporarily stopped. But other molecules of same species are moving down, which are present in mobile phase. When the molecule is present in mobile phase, it is moving down. In this way, the molecule is sometimes it is adsorbed and sometimes it is desorbed. And these adsorbed desorbed states are rapidly exchanged. It means that each molecule is spending some time in the stationary phase and some time in the mobile phase. But this time is highly irregular and it depends on the accidental energy gained by the molecule from the internal environment of column. Migration of solute molecule down the column is independent of other molecules and it is highly irregular. Bandwidth increases as the solute molecules migrate down the column. If suppose this is the column and these are the solute molecules injected in the column, Now they are present in the upper portion of column, and this band is known as narrow band. But when the solute molecules travel down the column, they will get dispersed, they will get spread in the column, and now the band, such band is known as broad band. When broad band is eluted from column, the peak will be broad and the width will be more, peak width will be more. Bandwidth is directly related to the retention time and inversely proportional to the mobile phase velocity. Band broadening is better explained by Van Deemter equation. The equation is H is equal to A plus B upon mu plus C mu, where H is HETP, that is height equivalent to theoretical plate, A is eddy diffusion, B is longitudinal diffusion, C is mass transfer, resistance to mass transfer, and mu is average linear velocity of mobile phase. Now, this is the typical Van Deemter plot where optimum mobile phase velocity is required to get maximum number of plates and minimum plate height, that is minimum HETP. When eddy diffusion, longitudinal diffusion, resistance to mass transfer, these terms are minimum and there is optimum mobile phase velocity, then HETP will be minimum, that is height equivalent to theoretical plate will be minimum. And when the height equivalent to theoretical plate is minimum, number of theoretical plates will be maximum. As the number of theoretical plates are more, separation will be good. Rate theory is better explained by using this Van Deemter equation. We'll see each term of this equation in detail next. First is eddy diffusion, that is A, which is also known as multiple path effect. Eddy diffusion results from irregularities in flow velocities and path length around the packing. Eddy diffusion is calculated by using formula A is equal to lambda dp, where dp is the particle diameter of stationary phase and lambda is the function of packing uniformity and column geometry. If the column is not packed uniformly, then unequal path length may exist in the column. Some solute molecules of same species may travel fast and get eluted first. But other molecules may travel long distance or long path and get eluted later. Now suppose this is the column which is not packed uniformly and sample is injected to this column. Now these molecules are belonging to same species, but color is given different just for understanding. Here the blue colored molecule has traveled short path and get eluted fast, while the red colored molecule has traveled average distance, but the green colored molecule has taken largest path and traveled slowly and get eluted lastly. So in this way, blue will form front of the peak, red molecules, that is average, the molecules which have traveled average distance, they will form middle of the peak, and the molecules which have traveled largest path, they will form end of the peak or tail of the peak. It means that if some molecules, if they have taken very large path, they will eluted from the column very slowly, and as they are eluted slowly, the peak width or band width will increase. To minimize eddy diffusion, mean diameter of particle in the column packing should be as small as possible and the column should be packed uniformly. That means if we want to minimize this multiple path effect, if we want to travel all the solute molecules with average velocity, then the column packing should be uniform and the particle diameter should be as small as possible. This is about eddy diffusion. Second term is longitudinal diffusion, that is B. It is also known as axial diffusion. As the band of solute molecules travel in mobile phase, it will tend to diffuse in all directions due to random molecular movement of solute molecule. It means that the solute molecules will get dispersed in less concentrated region from the highly concentrated regions. It is calculated by using formula B is equal to 2 gamma dm, where gamma is the obstruction factor. It depends upon column packing uniformity, and dm is the solute diffusion coefficient in mobile phase. Now suppose this is the column and these solute molecules are injected in the column. In longitudinal diffusion, what happens when the solute molecules travel down the column due to the mobile phase velocity? They will start dispersing in all directions. They will start diffusing on in all directions in the less concentrated regions. And as the molecules travel down in the column, the distribution or the diffusion of these solute molecules is more. And such band is called as broad band. Now, why this diffusion occurs? If mobile phase velocity is low, then the high diffusion rates of solute molecule in mobile phase can cause solute molecules to disperse axially, and due to this they will get eluted slowly from the column. To minimize longitudinal diffusion, mobile phase velocity or mobile phase flow rate should be optimum. Generally it is high but optimum. This is about longitudinal diffusion. Next is mass transfer, CS and CM. It is resistance to mass transfer. The analyte takes certain amount of time to get equilibrated between stationary and mobile phase. The term CS results from resistance to mass transfer at the solute to stationary phase interface. CS is directly proportional to the effective thickness of stationary phase, that is DF, and inversely proportional to the diffusion coefficient of solute in stationary. Now CS means resistance to mass transfer in stationary phase. Now what is this resistance to mass transfer? It means that the solute molecule enters in the stationary phase slowly as well as it exits the stationary phase slowly. This is resistance to mass transfer. Suppose these are the two stationary phase particles, one is smaller one and other one is larger one, and these are the two solute molecules. One enters in small particle and other enters in the large particle. But it is observed that the particle which enters in the larger stationary phase particle, the movement of solute is slow. That means resistance to mass transfer is there. It is more in that case. While in smaller particle, the resistance to mass transfer is less. So the solute molecule from smaller stationary phase particle will get eluted fast, while from the larger particle it will elute slowly. Now slower movement within the stationary phase means longer time spent by the solute molecule in the stationary phase, while other molecules are moving forward with the mobile phase. Now this is about CS. If the mobile phase velocity is high and the mass transfer rate is slow, then the solute band will be broad. Now this is about resistance to mass transfer with stationary phase, that is CS. Now we'll see the term CM. The term CM represents resistance to mass transfer between adjacent streams of mobile phase. It is directly proportional to the square of particle diameter of column packing and inversely proportional to the diffusion coefficient of solute in mobile phase. So both these terms CS and CM, they will contribute in HET. The last term is average linear velocity of mobile phase, that is mu. At low velocity of mobile phase, longitudinal diffusion will be more, and at high velocity of mobile phase, CS, that is resistance to mass transfer from stationary phase, will be more. And in both these cases, band broadening will be there. So, to obtain efficient separation, mobile phase velocity should be optimum. Finally, we can say that small and uniform particle size of stationary phase, uniform column packing and optimum velocity of mobile phase will give large number of theoretical plates or smaller HETP, and due to this there will be good separation. So this is about rate theory, Van Deemter equation. Next we'll see column efficiency parameters. The efficiency of column is expressed by number of theoretical plates in column or by height equivalent to theoretical plate. Large number of theoretical plate or smaller HETP will give good separation. A theoretical plate is the distance on column in which equilibrium is attained between solute in mobile phase and stationary phase. If the number of theoretical plates are more, we'll get the good peak shape, that is Gaussian curve shape peak, if the number of theoretical plates are more. And if we have two solutes in same sample, two solute mixture in same sample, the separation will be good. If the number of theoretical plates are less or HETP is more, then the peak will be broad. And due to these broad peaks, these peaks will get overlap with each other, and in this case the separation will be poor. Broad peaks with poor separation when number of theoretical plate is low. Column efficiency parameters, that is number of theoretical plate and height equivalent to theoretical plate. These are the two column efficiency parameters. The number of theoretical plates can be calculated by using formula N is equal to L upon H. There is one more formula, N is equal to retention time upon deviation bracket square. It can also be, when the equation is further derived, it will give N is equal to 16 in bracket retention time of solute upon peak width bracket square, peak width at base. And next is N is equal to 5.54 in the bracket retention time upon peak width at half height bracket square. By using these formula we can calculate number of theoretical plates. So this is about the theories of chromatography, plate theory, rate theory, HETP and column efficiency parameters. I hope you understood all these points. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel and share this video. And thank you for watching my video.